Fantastic. The solution for this is pretty straightforward based upon what we've already seen. Firstly, we walk through all of the tile sets inside of the map object that we've created. For each one of them, we create a new image, set its onload function, and then set its source name. Once we're loaded, effectively we increment the image load count variable. And then we test whether or not the image load count variable is equal to the number of tile sets that could potentially occur. So effectively we're saying, are number of images loaded equal to number of images that exist? If so, we can set fully loaded equal to true. Now, you'll notice one annoying little variance of the JSON format for tiled, is that the image path is actually an absolute path to the file from where the editor and base file were formed. So effectively, what this is saying is that given the path to tiled, there's some really crazy file path to actually get to the gritsmaster PNG from the source file we're using. So to properly load that, what we'd like to do is strip out all of the other data that's not just the file name, and then append the file name to our data directory. Now this is because our editing environment may be in a different directory structure than our production environment that users are actually playing. For grits, we use this nifty little regular expression here that allowed us to replace all of the data before the final slash with blank characters, giving us the file name for this image. We appended that file name to the ... data directory, giving us the source.